But Yuvi, what an incredible comeback it was for you at the World Cup. You just came out of, some would say, somewhat of a slump, but you just blew everyone away with that incredible performance. Player of the year, highest run getter, highest wicket taker. Any one moment that stood out for you?
Well, a lot of moments in the World Cup, but as you said before, the World Cup was having a tough time and everything came well together. But I think in the World Cup, the loss against South Africa was the turning point for all the boys, I guess. And we had a team meeting and decided that, you know, everything is going well for us, but this is the moment that we need to be together. At the moment, everything was going against and there's a lot of criticism and you know, a lot of chat about how Indian team is going to go in the next round. So I think regrouping at that moment was the moment for me in the World Cup.
And Yuvi, now of course you're perhaps getting itchy fingers sitting out the England tour, but how's that finger doing? Is it getting better?
Yeah, it's been tough. You know, I was looking forward on the England tour, got injured, came back, and now looking forward to come back on the field as soon as possible.
I saw that you tweeted Kevin Peterson. You have an ongoing thing with him. You said now you can finally score some runs because the pie chucker is not playing.
Well, he started first saying that are you scared of bowling to me? So I said, you know, it's going to be a different ball game playing in India. So I can get some runs if I'm not bowling to you.
Sunil Gavaskar, if I can just ask you, what was the one big difference between 1983 and 2011?
Well, easy. Actually, very easy. I think the 1983 team was a better looking team than the 2011.
You got to respond to that. Both of you, in fact, because both of them have a huge following. Yuvi?
Well, I think he's right. I think we got a group of quite ugly looking boys. So I definitely would say that 83 was a better looking side.
Okay. I know a large number of women who would disagree. Mr. Jetley, just a quick word from you about Yuvraj, and then we'll come to Srishant in just a second. But is he that great all-rounder, the elusive all-rounder that the Indian team is in many ways still looking for?
Well, he's been here for more than a decade, so you can't call him that he's an all-rounder we're looking for. He served us well for more than 10 years now. And I think when he gets going, nobody can stop him, and we saw it in the T20 World Cup, right, what he achieved there.
Srishant, I wanted to ask you, you told us shortly after the World Cup that you gave 200%, but your performance, you said, was perhaps 1 out of 10. You gave 20 out of 10, but it was 1 out of 10. So you tried hard. I mean, full marks for trying.
Absolutely. I was fortunate enough to get an opportunity, honestly. Thank God's been kind, and thanks to Dhoni and the management that I could take the new ball. The first ball ever bowled by an Indian in 2011 World Cup was me. Even then, Zach Bhai was there. I think Dhoni gave it to me, and for me, that was a great honor. And to be standing with all the legends and everything, I think it's a great honor. So about the performance, I think I gave my very best, and it's cricket, it's not PlayStation. So you need to keep running in hard and keep trying your very best, and some days you do really well, some days you don't. But I just want to keep going strong, and hopefully, God willing, if I'm still fit and raring to go, maybe the next World Cup I'll be winner.
Absolutely, Srishant, and I'm sure we'll see you back very soon. Thanks very much indeed, all of you guys. Just stay on with us. If I can just get both of you to just step back. My colleague Vikram Chandra is just going to come up in a second and introduce our next lot of players.
Well, we did say...
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.